Hi to all. In this video, we are going to see no load current of a transformer. Okay, the phasor sum of magnetizing current Im and the loss component of current I1. So Im is calculated using the MMF by per meter required for the core and yoke, and the respective length of the flux path. Okay, I1 is determined using the iron loss curve of the material used for the core and yoke, and the flux density employed and the weight. The no load current I0 is the vectoral, the no load current I0, this one is the vector sum of magnetizing current, vector sum of magnetizing current Im and core loss or working component current Ic. Okay. I naught is the vector sum of Ic and Im. Okay, function of Im is to produce flux phi m in the magnetic circuit, and the function of Ic is to satisfy the no load losses of the transformer. Okay, so I naught is equal to square root of I naught is equal to square root of Ic square plus Im square ampere. Okay, transformer under no load condition. This is a diagram. Okay, we are not giving any load to the secondary, we are giving supply to the primary, but we didn't connect any load to the secondary. This condition is called no load condition. No load input to the transformer is equal to V1 I0 cos phi naught. So V1 I0 is equal to no load losses as per output in 0 and input, that is called output plus losses. Since the copper loss under no load condition is almost negligible, because we are not connecting any load here, so copper loss is very few. Okay, copper loss is nothing but I square R loss. So if we are not connecting any load, the I value will be not present in the secondary. So it's a negligible one. Since the copper loss under no load condition is almost negligible, the no load losses can entirely be taken as due to core loss only. So thus the core loss components of the no load current Ic is equal to core loss by V1. Ic is equal to core loss by V1 for single phase transformer. So core loss per phase by V1 phase is for three phase transformer. Okay, RMS value of magnetizing current Im is equal to magnetizing ampere turns max value by square root of 2 multiplied with T1, with the assumptions that the magnetizing current is sinusoidal, which is not true in practice. Okay, the magnetic circuit of a transformer consists of both iron and air path. The iron path is due to legs and yokes, and air path is due to unavoidable joints created by the core composed of different shaped stamplings. If all the joints are assumed to be equivalent to an air gap of LG, then the total ampere turns for the transformer magnetic circuit is equal to 80 plus 80,000. Like BM, therefore Im is equal to 80 for iron plus 8 lakhs LG BM by root 2 T1. One piece stamping impact is performed. Two piece stamping called for use of coils on the legs. Note, in case of transformer normal design, the no load current will generally be less than 2%, because you know transformer is the most efficient electrical equipment. Okay, the efficiency of the transformer is always more than 90%. No load power factor cos phi is equal to Ic by I0 and will be around 0.2. Transformer copper losses, the primary copper loss at no load is negligible as I0 is very less. Okay, the secondary copper loss is zero at no load because we are not going to give any supply, any load. So there is no current flow in that. So the copper loss is zero as no current flows in the secondary winding at no load. Okay, core or iron loss. Next one, the total core loss is equal to core loss in legs plus core loss in yokes. The core loss can be estimated at design stage by referring to graph of core loss per kg versus flux density. Okay, core loss in leg is equal to core loss by kg in leg multiplied with weight of leg in kg. That is equal to loss by kg in leg multiplied with volume of the leg and multiplied with density of steel or iron used. Core loss in yoke. So, loss per kg in yoke and multiplied with volume of yoke. Ay multiplied with mean length of the yoke and density of iron used. The density of iron or steel used transformer lies between 7.5 to 7.8 grams per cc. Thank you.